Hello again. The time is just gone 3:30 on the 21st of August, 2013. What is time? Well, time is that which can be, or that which persists. Time in its basic state, in its most limited state, is a Planck time. We just click in, put in a link for that one. No less amount of time than that exists in theory. Whether it exists in actuality, that's pure speculation. So everything that we experience is made up of Planck times. We'll put in another link here, just a second. Planck clock, let's just have a quick look at that. This is what the Planck clock tries to explain. One Planck time. Do we need a link for that? Let's have a quick look. No, we've got a link for that. One Planck time is 1⁻⁴³ of a second. Let's have a quick look at what that means. Right. If you want to know what 1⁻⁴³ of a second is, that's the link to get your head around that one. So, as we move along the clock, as the clock moves along, we come to 1 second after that many Planck times. Big number, a big small number. And then that many Planck times is a Planck minute, or 1 minute as we understand it. That's an hour. That's how many plank times there are in a day. How many in a week? How many in a month? How many in a year? How many in 10 years? How many in 100 years? How many in 1,000 years? How many in 10,000 years? So on and so forth. All the way along to a black hole. That's the most time that we know of that exists in the universe. A black hole lasts for 1 raised to the 100th power years, and that's how many Planck times are in 1 raised to the 100th power years. Dizzying numbers, aren't they? Then we need to understand linear time. Another link there. When you hear the expression linear time, it means that time travels in one direction only. So when we wake up in the morning, for instance, we aren't doing what we were doing yesterday at 3 o'clock. We're doing something completely new. I haven't worked out in my own mind what linear time is yet in a way that I can convey easily, but you can rest assured that as soon as I've got that formed in my own mind in a way that can easily be presented to yours, I will do a entry on linear time. But you can look up the let's look at what linear time means. I'm not sure why it's not L-I-N-E-A-R. Right. In mathematics, the designating or involving an equation whose terms are of the first degree. Let's see what it says in Wikipedia. See what it says here. You could do this yourself, I know, but I'm interested to see what happens when we go through these things. Oh, altogether too technical for me. However, if you so inclined, that's the page to try and get into it. Dum bum bum. What else might be useful to know? Okay, then a summary. Time is that which can be or persist, which we can recognize as being and persisting. There's a theoretical limit to the minimum amount of time that can exist. That's that link. And there's a maximum ascertained value for the most amount of time that can exist in the universe. That's a black hole time, 1 raised to the 100th power years, or thereabouts. The actual largest, the number I actually came across while checking that one out was 1 raised to the 98.6th power years, which is pretty well 1 raised to the 100th. However, that's the physical universe which we currently live in. As you may be aware by now, this website maintains or asserts that there's a thing called straight line action, straight line action time, we'll make that as quick link in there just a sec. There's the link for that one. Straight line action time is what we evolve, we are evolving through time to attain. Straight line action time itself is an unlimited, or it potentially it's endless, but this website has currently put the amount of time we currently experience straight line action time for is another link, I think. That's another power of a number. That number, interestingly, is what a Greek mathematician or arithmetist of a couple of thousand years ago considered to be the largest number we would ever need. There's no other number that is used in science that has got any comes anywhere close to being that big. But in fact, the biggest number is the black hole time length number, and this, as you can appreciate, or hopefully will come to appreciate, is so much bigger than 1 raised to the 100th power. It makes the length of the universe less than a blink of an eye. In the light, if that was the lifetime of a person, the length of the time a black hole exists for would be less than the blink of an eye in a lifetime, just to give you some idea. So that's what we're working towards, the heavenly state. That's covered. Oh, we haven't got another link, just a moment. No, we don't need to put in the heavenly state as a link, because that's covered. You'll find the heavenly state in that link there. So, another quick finalize. Another quick final summary. Time is that which can be and persist through time. I think that's the short way of putting it. Time is that which can be and persist. Right, there's just there's probably one more consideration that we need to just have a quick think about. Although each Planck time is separate, our experience of reality is a continuous flow. But there is a distinct break between each Planck time. So we need that bridge of incomprehension explained as to how it becomes a continuous experience. That is, why is something that is discontinuous experienced as being continuous? We might be back into linear time here. We'll make a quick note of that. Might be a screencast for a future time. On second thoughts, I'm just going to put an entry in for a future screencast, and it suddenly occurred to me, the reason we don't experience the discontinuity is because the discontinuity, the break, that which exists between each Planck time, is the nothing. We better have a link in for that one. And the link is space. Sorry, this is taking a little bit longer than it should do. I don't know which one I need here. Yeah, that one. Right. Cool. I think we'll leave it at that. Right, as we say, has been said, if something important, which puts this all into a nutshell in a much simpler way, arises, then it will be included in a new screencast. I doubt whether this is going to be the final one for this. Right, guys and gals, or gals and guys, should we say? Just have a quick look and see how long that took. 45 minutes. Well, I just hope my time was worth your time. Okay, see you later.